Have you ever wondered how nuclear energy is produced? How it works? If you have, or even if you haven't, make sure you watch this video till the end. Despite all the cosmic energy that the word nuclear invokes, nuclear power plants don't operate that differently from a typical coal-burning power plant. Confused? Let me explain. Coal-burning power plants, well, burn coal in order to produce heat, which is then used to heat water into steam. This pressurized steam drives a turbine generator in order to produce energy. Nuclear power plants do the same thing. Heat is produced, which is used to heat water into pressurized steam, which drives a turbine generator. The key difference between a nuclear power plant and a coal-burning power plant is the way they produce the heat. We burn coal in order to produce heat in coal-burning power plants, but to produce heat in nuclear power plants, a process called fission takes place. Fission, in simple words, just means to split an atom into two. Splitting an atom releases enormous amounts of heat, which then drives a turbine generator to produce energy. Nuclear fission is not as simple as that, though. Now, I am going to go extremely deep into nuclear fission. So, if you don't want to get too confused, you can skip to the next part of the video using the timestamps in the description. To understand nuclear fission, you need to have an idea of what atomic mass is. If you don't, it is basically the number of protons plus the number of neutrons in an atom. For understanding this concept here, let's take the example of uranium. Uranium-235, to be specific. 235 is the atomic mass of the uranium I have mentioned here. Uranium can have different atomic masses too. But let's stick to uranium-235 here. Now, what we will do is that we will shoot a high energy neutron towards this atom, which will change its atomic mass from 235 to 236 because we added a neutron. Uranium-236 is very unstable compared to uranium-235. Thus, it undergoes fission. Uranium-236 splits into two atoms, krypton and barium. The atomic masses of the two are 92 and 141, that is krypton 92 and barium 141. You may notice that the atomic masses of the two atoms only add up to 233. Please remember that atomic mass is the sum of the number of protons and the number of neutrons in the atom. The number of protons will remain the same. Thus, there are three neutrons which are missing. These neutrons are now independent. As complicated as it is getting, I have to tell you how heat is produced here. So please bear with me. Einstein's famous equation pops in here. E equals mc square. However, this equation is technically incomplete. The actual equation is this. Energy equals change in mass into speed of light whole squared. The key word here is change. So, the change in mass is of 3 neutrons, or precisely the number of grams you see on screen. Thus, the energy produced is that number multiplied by the square of the speed of light. Thus, the energy produced is what you see on screen. It's easy to forget that as teensy an amount that may be, that is the energy produced by just the change in mass of 3 neutrons. I must point out here that the change in mass is not constant because some neutrons may be used to continue the chain reaction or, in simple words, continue to hit other uranium-235 atoms in order to cause more nuclear fission. This method of initiating nuclear fission is called neutron bombardment. There are a few things to be noted here. Though it is not necessary to use uranium-235 for nuclear fission, it is necessary to use a radioactive element for nuclear fission because they are unstable. The radioactive elements are marked on the periodic table on screen. Also, to prevent disasters from happening, graphite control rods are used, as you can see in this diagram. It absorbs neutrons and gamma rays, reducing and eventually preventing the rate of fission. This is so that extra energy is not produced, which may lead to deadly explosions. In nuclear weapons, however, graphite is not used because, well, the explosion and emission of gamma rays is the desired output. So, this was a basic theoretical understanding of how nuclear energy is produced in nuclear reactors. There are a number of minute details to this, however, when practically producing nuclear energy. So, please keep that in mind. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then make sure you smash the like button and share this video. Don't forget to subscribe as well. It would mean a lot to me. Thanks for watching.